morning and welcome to my second session. So yesterday we started the chapter that is reproduction in organism. One thing that you have to remember, while you are seeing the movies, so there you will impress by seeing their trailers. So like that, so whichever topic that you are going to discuss, first you must and should know about it. What are the concepts that mainly hidden inside that chapter? So reproduction in organism, that chapter mainly includes the lifespan and reproduction. In reproduction, mainly there are two types. One is asexual reproduction and another one is a sexual reproduction. Yesterday we discussed about the lifespan and today we are going to discuss about the reproduction, definition of reproduction and asexual reproduction and sexual, where that will be occurs and which kind of organism they are involved in the asexual reproduction and which kind of organisms they are involved in the sexual reproduction. I have mentioned that reproduction and their types and where that exactly occurs. So first one, reproduction. The definition of reproduction. Reproduction means it is a biological process in which the organism can give rise to the young ones that is similar to itself. Similar to itself means what? Horse can produce the horse baby, dog can produce the dog baby, and even human can produce the human baby itself. That is we consider as the organism can reproduce itself. In reproduction, there are mainly two types. One is asexual reproduction and another one is a sexual reproduction. So asexual reproduction, where exactly it will be happens? So it will be happens in the lower organism. Lower organisms means microorganisms and some of the plants and some of the animals. And sexual reproduction that mainly occurs in the higher organisms. Higher organisms means what? Plants and as well as the animals. So you have to ask the one question, sir, whether asexual reproduction that can also occurs in plant and as well as the animals? Oh yes. So even in animals also, there are the some lower organisms. So even some animals, they don't have the ability to highly develop. Some organisms or some animals, they are comes under the asexual reproduction. It is nothing but one of the chemical process, one of the chemical reactions that already you have heard the name, that is the DNA. DNA, it is one of the genetic material that has the ability to construct the new organism. So while you are discussing about the cell, inside the cell we have the nucleus, inside the nucleus we have the DNA. That DNA can get the ability to replicate and transcription and translation finally produces the proteins. These proteins can construct the whole exact body of an organism. So that is the exact phenomenon that occurs inside each and every living organism. So if so here bacteria is the bacteria, it is a cell wall, and inside the bacteria they form of nuclei. So they don't have the nucleus. On the basis of nucleus, organisms will be divided into two types. That is one prokaryotic organism, another one is an eukaryotic organism. In prokaryotic organism, they don't have the true nucleus, but they have the DNA that is in the form of nuclei. So at the time of cell division, so here the one process is called as a cell division. In cell division, what happens? This one cell can mainly exactly divides into two parts. So this one cell can exactly divides into two parts. So the cell which produces the two parts, that mainly gets the nucleus in the equal distribution. So then only can get the ability to produce in the new organism. Cell division, mitosis, cell divisions only occurs in the asexual reproduction. So that you have to remember, mitosis cell division, so that is occurs in the asexual reproduction. But in sexual reproduction, first organisms can possess the mitosis and then next through the meiosis it produces the gamete, that is the egg and as well as the sperm, that we commonly call as a male gamete and as well as the female gamete. Organisms mainly divided into the five kingdoms. So first one is kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi or the Mycota, and kingdom Plantae and as well as the Animalia. Out of the five kingdom classification, Monera, Protista and fungi. So these are comes under the asexual reproduction. So remaining two kingdom, that is the plant and as well as the animals, the maximum organisms comes under the sexual reproduction, and there are some minimum organisms comes under the asexual reproduction. So let's we begin with the types of asexual reproduction. Binary fission, budding, fragmentation, sporulation, and even as well as the encystation. So let's we start with the first one, that is binary fission. Binary fission that commonly occurs in the amoeba. So let's discuss what exactly happens in the amoeba. Already we know that amoeba, it is an unicellular organism. They have the single cell, and inside the single cell, so we have the nucleus, because it is an eukaryotic organism. So once it undergoes the asexual reproduction, so that is through the mitosis cell division process. So which process it occurs? Mitosis. Once it undergoes the mitosis cell division process, the nucleus also start to divide in the equally. So here nucleus, so will distribute it equally. So first it forms and furrows. That furrows can give rise to the differentiation of nucleus. So this is the nucleus. At the last stage, finally, one amoeba can produce the two parental amoeban cells. Each amoeban cell have the nucleus. So this is the type of binary fission. In binary fission, main thing that we have to remember, so whether any cell, like an amoeba, it also has the nucleus. Along with the nucleus, inside the cell, they have the cytoplasm. So at the time of the mitosis process, at the time of the asexual reproduction process, so the distribution of cytoplasm will be occurs, and your distribution of nucleus also occurs. So if the cytoplasm will be equally distributed, so that is called as the cytosis, and the equal distribution of nucleus, so it is called as a. And the next one begins with the budding. Budding process that commonly occurs in the yeast cell. So let's we start with cell. This also has the spherical structures. So at the time of their growth, they forms and the extra and outer cell. So that is called as an buds. So here, due to their growth, due to their differential cell division process, that forms an extracellular cell. So this extracellular cell, it is called as a buds. So these buds, in the later stages, after their maturation, can get separated from the parental body and can form the individual new cell. So this is called as a budding. In budding also what happens, they also have the nucleus, and this nucleus also equally distributed at the time of the formation of buds. So at the finally at the finally separation of buds, they can give rise to the individual organism. So this is in the budding. And next one, fragmentation. So as already you know that fragmentation means what? The cutting the small pieces. So while cutting the small pieces, these small individual pieces can give rise to the new organism. So where that will be happens? So it will be happens in the planaria. So this the fragmentation process, it exactly happens in the planaria organism. In planaria organism, what happens? So if you make into these small pieces, that is called as the fragments. So these individual fragments can give rise to the individual new species. So this is called as a fragmentation process. And the next one is the sporulation process. In sporulation, within a protective cell layer, this process is called as a sporulation. This sporulation process can occur in every organism, the lower organisms. So for example, so even in the conidia, penicillium, and some of the climadam, the juice goes inside the climadamonas. And the another important process that related to the sporulation, that is called as an encystation. In encystation, what happens? The protective layer that can surround these spores, that this process is called as an encystation. In encystation, what happens? The small spores, they can protect it by the protective cell covering layer. That layer formation is called as an encystation. So here, some asexual reproductive structures present in the lower organism. So those are gametes in the Asexual sponges, conidia in the penicillium, juice spores in the cladodomonas and birds found in the hydra. So you can easily remember by their pronunciation. So as a genus, so here you can remember that G commonly found in the sponges, conidia that is the N pronunciation is found in the penicillium, juice spore is present in the cladodomonas and birds is found in the hydra. The commonly the flower producing plants, they can produce the flowers. After the flower formation, they can produce the fruits and that fruits can give rise to the seed. These seeds can get the ability to formation of the new plant. But there are some plants without seed, they can easily grow the new plant. So that is the process is called as a vegetative propagation. Which are the structures involved under the vegetative propagation process? Those are called as a vegetative propagules. So if you are confusion regarding the remembering what exactly the vegetative means, so veg and non veg, that is veg it belongs to the plant product. So here some of the common example, rhizome it is found in the ginger and stem tuber in the potato and leaf buds in the bryophyta and offset in the water hyacinth. Water hyacinth it is commonly called as an Bengal. Why it is called as a terror of Bengal? Because due to their asexual reproductive capacity, even per day within a week that can invade the lot of area. So while growing inside the water, it can drain up the maximum oxygen. If it drains the maximum oxygen, so that oxygen quantity will be automatically reduced inside the water body, that can lead into the decline in the fishes and even that can cause us the fish mortality. Along with the fish mortality, some aquatic animals can may die. So that